Good afternoon. My name is Vincent Panhuizen. I'm one of the three owners of Kahn Architecten. Our office is based in Rotterdam, the Netherlands, and Sao Paulo. Today I will show you the new building of the Supreme Court in The Hague. It's in the Netherlands. It's a project which started as it's a PPP. It means a private-public partnership. That means that you have to compete with another four consortia for 1.5 years. And you have to make more than only a plan as an architect, but you also have to make a contract for 30 years maintenance, operational, and all these things for 30 years long. So that means that you also have to make a plan, including choice of three kinds of cheese in the restaurants for 30 years. So you really have to do this with a very big team. Supreme Court in the Netherlands, up till the 1990s, this was the building of the Supreme Court. It was a very solemn building with these nice steps and the statues in front of it. Really a representative building for a governmental institute. This building, it was demolished in 1990, and at that time the Supreme Court was spread over different buildings all over in the center of The Hague. And also these beautiful statues, they disappeared from the public space of the city. Our mission was to make a new building for the Supreme Court, to bring together again all the people from the Supreme Court in one building so they can work together and also make the Supreme Court visible for the city again. This is a private person. He's changing into a representative of the justice just by wearing a wig and a robe. And that's in fact what we also should do with this building, a building which will be representative for the justice and also recognizable. Shortly, the program, mainly it's office workspace for the Supreme Court. Then there is a part of public program where the adjustments will be done. And we have an operational part for the management of this institute. This is the volume. It's 22 meters deep, 104 meters long, 27 meters high. This is given by the urbanists. And in this volume, the program exactly fits. That's how we started this competition. We made a division in a quite logical way. Public program connected to the street level, so open to the society. Then we have an operational part for the management, and on top of that, the workspace for the Supreme Court. The first three levels you can see as a mass, as a pedestal. It's completely made out of natural stone, and we carved out in this mass over the whole length of the building a space which contains the public program. And this pedestal, it is supporting a glazing superstructure. And within this glazing superstructure, we have the workspace of the Supreme Court. So a pedestal carved open, this space together with the space underneath the trees. There are beautiful trees in front of this building. It's a really typical urban place in The Hague with beautiful green, and underneath these trees the space in the building is continuing, and it really makes an urban special place into the city. This is one of these special green spaces in The Hague. So you could say the building, it stands for what it is, the Supreme Court. On one hand, open to the society, so with his feet on the ground, and on open to the society because they really have to know what's going on in the society, and on the other hand, with their head in the clarity of knowledge and facts, so they can make a decision, a judgment in a sovereign way. The building, it's a freestanding building, so you will have, we made all these facades all around in the same way, so it's recognizable as a Supreme Court from out of every perspective in the city. So, from underneath the trees, open, 104 meters long, you can look into this public program. This is a plan of the ground floor, and you can see the white that are the foyers, the waiting areas in front of the courtrooms, the courtrooms in the back. So that it's really one open area. In front of the building, these six legal scholars, these statues, with behind them the text where justice ends, war starts. Some pictures from this space, the foyers, which are connected all together. And you can see there's only a very thin piece of glass in between the public space outside and the public program inside. So briefly, we have public program on the ground floor, then the management on top of this, and on top of this tabletop, we have the workspace for the Supreme Court. And in this area, we lined up three domains. One domain for the prosecution, a domain for the judges, and in between a domain for the board, the daily board. And this is very important, of course, for the for a court, that the separation of powers must be very clear. You have the prosecution and the judges. So within this building, behind this glazing facade, we have three different domains with their own atmosphere. Three different houses. And behind this glazing wall, this glazing wall, it's made out of lamellas from stainless steel. And that gives privacy on one hand, but it also makes it possible to make windows from floor to ceiling, so you have very light and bright work areas. This is a plan. It's a quite deep building. We organize all the workspace along the facade. It's 22 meters deep, so in the middle it's quite difficult to you have to bring daylight over there, otherwise you can't use it. And in the middle, it was very important to make the meeting areas where the people of the Supreme Court can work together. So we made light wells. You can see in this section a few light wells, and they're going four levels deep. This brings in a lot of daylight. If I go to the domain of the councils, this is one of the renders of the competition. You can see we have these light wells going four levels down, and it really makes a very generous space where people can meet, have coffee, have the libraries, and can work together. In the court, we used in this shared space in between a straight natural stone with very sharp corners. Here you can see light coming from above. With the meeting tables around these voids. Here you see the corridor with all the offices on the left side, and there are voids in the voids, which gives addresses to the most important rooms, the most important meeting rooms of this institute. Then if we go to the other side of the building, there we have the prosecution, and it's very important if you are in this working area that you can feel that you are going to a different section. So in this section, we made all the corners round and we used a different stone, a stone with more colors. and the corners are rounded, and the voids have different forms. And if you walk in a building, you always can feel, now I'm in the section of the persecution. Looking from the top floor down, and on the other way around. Then in the middle we have a small house of the board, the Procurator General and the President. For them, we took something from the home, what they left, with a lot of marble and nice. It was a small domain, so we made a small house. We used the same kind of stone, and we give them also a quite intimate domain within this huge building. Then going down again, we have the wall, behind this wall, the courtrooms. The courtrooms we really had to make introvert, so no outside, from outside to inside, but we wanted to give them daylight, so we used this very thin alabaster, which it's translucent, so there's no view between inside and outside, but they always have this. You always have daylight in the courtroom. This is just a Photoshop image. We collected all these sheets and made a very nice story in a vertical way. But there's always daylight in this courtroom during the day. So that's it.
Can you explain me? It's a kind of strange dichotomy between the interior, which is white and elegant and pure, and the exterior, which is very severe and very has a very strong, severe facade towards the city. Which was do you have some constraints in relation to the buildings or to the surrounding? How do you design the facade and the building in relation to the surrounding?
So the ground floor is completely open.
Yeah.
And you really feel that the urban space underneath these trees are continuing.
With the square.
Yeah, and the ceilings in the ground floor, they are exactly as high as the underside of the crowns of the trees. So that works very well. Okay. You feel it as one big space. The material of the ground floor, it's a kind of greenish natural stone, so it really goes together. And on top of it, yeah, we made this superstructure in a quite abstract way. I think the Supreme Court should also act as, on one hand, open to the society, but on the other hand, also as an abstract institute, which can work on a sovereign way. And that's why we made this curtain. Normally you see each 7.20 meters a column, and that makes an office an office. But here we really were looking for this abstract view.
So the whiteness is related to this symbolic vision of the building as a purity of the institution, the laws
exactly.
For everybody. Yeah. This was a discussion with your client? I mean, how was the dialogue?
They wanted to have a kind of iconic building, recognizable, and I liked very much, it was a competition, they liked very much our idea that, yeah, the building is showing exactly what they do, on one hand trying to understand what's going on in the society, but on the other hand also, yeah, have their own domain without any interference from outside.
So it's a way to explain the idea of the institution in 21st century. Institution is still an institution,
yeah.
As a monument. In
but it's an interpretation of these days, of course, because the institute I show you at the beginning, that you really have to climb up to the stairs, but now it's more open to the public. Maybe within 100 years we have a different idea about that, but that's what they like to be now.
So this idea of transparency and also like pureness, everything white that represents maybe transparency and justice also, and has like how to show with the building what's the purpose of the people the judges, right, or justice. And so what I wanted to ask is that is it also like people coming, it's only offices for the judges and justice, or people come, normal people?
The ground floor, it's literally open to the public, so everyone can go in, can go into the courtrooms, join the adjustments. But on top of this, so out above the three layers, it's absolutely secret. You can't get there. So that's also, it's super secured. You really can't get in if you would try. That's not the idea. Yeah. Mm-hmm.